world champion, and I watch Inside Pitch.
Inside Pitch, your hosts Ray Bell and Mark Gray.
Welcome to yet another edition of Inside Pitch. For the next half hour, we'll give you our inside pitch on the people, places, and things making news in the world of sports. Hello, I'm Ray Bell.
Now, Mark Brinks.
Yeah, well, what's going on today?
Well, as usual, another show. We will have the Gurus out later on, too, so if you missed the previous show. But I'm going to be talking to James Washington of the world champion Dallas Cowboys. And yes, Ray, he's an ex-Bruin.
I knew that. I knew that. And I'll be talking, or joining me, rather, will be Manny Marquez, a master of the martial arts. And he will be showing us a thing or two about self-defense.
So, self-defense. So, I know he's going to come out here and do like a little demonstration. You can get involved in this, right? I want to see him, like, see if he can maybe throw you or something like that, maybe get involved in.
I don't think so. I mean, this guy's a master. I don't think he's going
to. That jacket fits loosely enough that you won't tear it or anything, will you?
People at home, you want to see me get hurt? I don't think so. You don't want to see me get hurt by a master, do you? No, I don't think so.
And the Gurus are back.
Yeah, you were talking. You kind of fluffed them off a little bit there.
No, I would never fluff the Gurus off. They're going to be out in the field again. They're kind of making a habit of this now. They went out to the. Are you ready for this? The Raider Et tryouts.
Yes, I think.
And a little birdie told me. I heard there's a rumor that they actually performed at the Raider Et tryouts.
I can't wait to see that.
Scary thought.
I cannot wait to see those guys performing. But let's take a little time out right now. But when we come back, Mark will be visited by a Bruin and Dallas Cowboy, James Washington. Stay tuned.
Jetson here with a glimpse of your future. The 21st century is really terrific. With just one exception. Smog.
Ollie, want a gift, Smith?
Fortunately, my house can rise above the air pollution, but your lungs can't. We could all use a breath of fresh air. Tell your parents to write or call the South Coast Air Quality Management District to find out how your family can help reduce pollution.
Dear Mom and Dad, it's been a long day, but then that's pretty typical for the CCC. We start off early every morning, and things just keep going from there. There's always something interesting to do, and new skills to learn. The best part is all the choices I have for the future. And if I stay a year, I can qualify for a scholarship. Gotta go. I'm off to class.
Join the CCC today. Call 1-800-952-JOBS.
I got into drugs, tricks, whatever it took. And it got so bad, that kind of life, like it was killing me. I don't know, maybe I was killing myself. I knew I needed help. So I'd heard about the teen canteen, and they said they could help me get clean. I told them all I wanted was a chance.
To find out more about the teen canteen, call 213-463-TEEN.
Welcome back. Joining me now is James Washington, safety for the Dallas Cowboys. James, welcome.
I'm glad to be here.
And are you sure? Because we were talking off stage, you realize that Ray, being the ex-Bruin, is not in this segment. I, the Trojan, am going to do the interview, so I hope that doesn't bother you.
Oh, no. I got two Rose Bowl rings, so I'm pretty happy about it.
I'll take it. What has it been like spending this offseason as a Super Bowl champion?
As a kid, you always dream about going to the Super Bowl, playing Sandlot in the fields and stuff like that. And to come back home where I played my college football, you know, at the Rose Bowl and win a Super Bowl in the Rose Bowl, where I already previous won two rings, now I have a Super Bowl ring there. I mean, it's like a dream come true.
Did you guys have a feeling as the season, when the season started and then as it progressed, that it was going to lead to that this year, this past year?
Well, we knew that we were going to be in the playoffs. When in the NFL, the biggest thing is to get to the playoffs. Mm-hmm. And anything that can happen during the playoffs, and that's what, you know, Jimmy preaches during the off season, is we get to the playoffs and then play our best games during the playoffs and it wind up being the Super Bowl champs.
Talking about Jimmy Johnson, what's it like to play for him? I mean, he is possessed by football. He lives for football day in, day out. Is he letting you guys have an off season at all?
No, it's just that he doesn't want to fail.
Right.
I'd rather play for a guy like that, and you know where he stands. You know that he's laying all the chips on the table, and he's dedicated himself to winning football games. And he's going to put the best guys out there on the field that he feels that can perform for him. Personally, personality as far as off the field, you know, you can't really get too much into that, you know. But on Sundays and all during the week, you know, we're preparing to win football games, and you know that he's on your side.
How are you preparing for this season, coming off a Super Bowl championship? Is it any more different to prepare now?
No, I'm a type of guy that I try to make things happen, and I just got to get to a certain level, kind of like, you know, as you would say, Michael Jordan, getting into your own zone.
Right.
Being the free safety, I definitely have to be into my own zone because I'm the one who basically quarterbacks the defense and makes sure that everybody lines up, making sure that everybody's doing the right thing. So it's no preparation. I mean, this is just one more year that I got an opportunity to grow in the Dallas defense, and I should know a lot more.
Talking about getting into the zone, what goes through your mind out there when you're on the field? And if there's going to be a pass, whether it's over the middle or deep, a fly pattern, if you're beat, everybody in the world sees it. How do you prepare for that mentally going out?
Yeah, it's funny because, you know, the defensive lineman can miss tackles all day. Linebackers can miss tackles all day. But if secondary miss a tackle, scoreboard seems to light up and everybody's dancing, you know. So, I mean, but you grow into that. I mean, we chose this position a long time ago. I mean, it wasn't like we just woke up and say, hey, the NFL is right there. I mean, when guys were out playing, you know, receiver, center, offensive lineman and stuff like that, you know, I was the guy that was covering guys, you know, when we used to play in the street. So you prepare yourself, and it's the pressure. I mean, some guys like pressure. Some guys take on pressure in different ways. And being a defensive back, you got to remember that we're always running backwards as fast as guys are running forward.
And talking about playing the position, I think it's like a prerequisite that most guys in the NFL, in college and in the NFL, in all football, get into trash talking, especially on the defensive side. Do you get into that at all?
Get into it quite a bit. I mean, I got Michael Irvin on my team, so I mean,
he's the king of that, isn't he? I mean, every time I see him, he's talking some kind of smack.
No, I mean, he don't see one thing you got to understand about Michael Irvin is that he talks trash, but he's probably in the offseason one of the hardest working people, and people don't see that. I mean, he talks trash because of the fact that he works hard day in and day out in the offseason, and he don't think, you know, he thinks he's the best because he works to be the best. So, I mean, it kind of carries over into our whole defensive attitude where people, you know, really didn't know us as far as named players. You know, we have a couple guys. You know, have Charles, you have Ken Norton. Mm-hmm. But besides that, our team as a defense wasn't noticed. Being the number one defense last year, we have a lot to prove this year, you know. And trash talking comes along with it.
Now, talking about the offseason, too, you've started a plan of yours in the offseason to build a homeless shelter in Los Angeles, an idea of yours. Why don't you share that with us a little bit?
Yeah, well, the homeless shelter itself is basically a rehab center, and it will shelter 30 to 40 people in the above part of the shelter, but the important part of the shelter is more of the rehabilitation. That's the bottom part. It's a 4,000-square-foot building, which will be focusing on the mentally ill and a drop-in, meaning the drop-in part will be dealing with kids, adults, and basic training. We have different programs, counseling. We're trying to get a doctor's office built into the shelter.
What made you start that? What made you come up with that idea?
Well, I mean, it's a need. like anything, when you go through life, you want to leave your mark, and you try to figure out a way that you can leave your mark. And being from Los Angeles, born and raised in Los Angeles, homeless has become, you know, not a problem, but an issue that faces our community. So I think that I can try to help the issue and better the situation.
It's a great idea, all the more power to you. It's great to see athletes getting involved in the community too, because you hear so many negative stories in sports. I think that that should come out a lot more. And you're also involved with the Easter Seals in Dallas. You're the chairman there.
Yeah, I'm the chairman of the Backer Fighter campaign in Dallas, which raises a great deal of dollars for them. I've been on board for the past 2 years, and this year will probably be my last year associated with that, because I plan to put most of my off-season time into my shelter.
Now, give us a little outlook on the season coming up. What do you see for the Dallas Cowboys?
I see Dallas Cowboys beating Washington Redskins on Monday night. I see that. Thereafter, I can't think.
Is that the first game?
That's the first game. And since the last, what was the Super Bowl? I don't remember the score. I mean, my focus has been on beating Washington Redskins on Monday night.
I see Jimmy Johnson has had a profound effect on you, because you just concentrated and focused on that first game and nothing else, which is why the Cowboys have been so successful.
That's the main reason. He's taught us. I mean, he's probably one of the best psychologists that I've ever played for as far as motivating players. I've seen him take guys, and the guys that play on his team is always labeled as a bad attitude. I mean, like myself. I mean, you look at Charles Haley and Michael Irvin's, guys who they say have a bad attitude, but how can you get these bad attitude guys to get out there and perform?
It could be the team of the 90s, but James, I'd like to thank you for coming on. Best of luck this year. Unfortunately, one of our gurus is not in the studio today. He's a diehard Cowboy fan, so we'd love to see you. But best of luck this year, and thanks for coming on. And best of luck with the shelter, too.
And thank you.
Let us know how that goes.
Thanks for having me.
Sure thing. And we will be right back. Actually, Ray will be right back, and he will be talking to Manny Marquez, martial arts master, right after this short break.
Strings. Branford Marsalis on the horn. Paul Schaefer on keys. Carly Simon on lead. There are a lot of different parts to play in the American Red Cross. Play your part.
Hi, I'm George Jetson with an important message from the 21st century. Despite all of our advances in technology designed to make life easier, we're still plagued by traffic congestion and smog. Air pollution is a growing problem in your century, too. But it doesn't have to be. For information on how you can help, contact the South Coast Air Quality Management District. Let's make the future crystal clear.
Welcome back. Joining me now is Manuel Marquez, martial arts expert. Welcome, Manuel. How are you?
Pretty good.
Man, you know, I'm sitting here and I'm a little nervous, man. I'm a little nervous thinking about the things that you can do as far as by being a master. It's almost unlimited as far as the expertise that you have.
Well, you got to remember, too, is if a true master is, he's supposed to be humble and respectable. So there's no fear then.
Now, a guy like yourself, how did you get started as far as being into martial arts?
The thing is I grew up in the projects. And for being in the projects, you had to defend yourself. And so this way, for the size that I was, I had to create some kind of protection, so I started training martial arts. This way, and then from that point, I started taking Taekwondo, Tangsudo, Motokwan of Korean arts. And then actually from there, I branched off into the Kung Fu arts.
Now, quickly, I know too that you worked a little bit with David Carradine on his series and current series now, Kung Fu. How is it to work with somebody that has no real martial arts background?
Patience. Patience, my friend. A lot of patience is virtue, because You gotta realize when people come into my school, they don't know anything about martial arts. That's when you have to mold them and build them from their foundation and create a movement into their mind physically, mentally, and spiritually.
A guy like myself, I'm looking at myself, do I have a shot at picking up any type of martial arts?
Yeah, you do.
Is there hope for me to learn anything?
Yes, there is.
There is? Okay, we're gonna take a little time out right now if we can. Just have you do a little couple of moves with your brother, who is a second degree black belt,
yes.
Reggie. And we just want to show some basic moves here, if we will. We'll unmic you, and we're all set. I think we're all set up for it. And here's Reggie right now.
Okay, the first.
And yeah, go ahead.
Okay, the first thing that we're going to do is to show basic movement. When people come in, they usually come in with a straightforward punch.
Uh-huh.
And so the motion of what we do in our Kung Fu system is blocking, coming in, and uprooting the body.
Wow.
So the motion is striking. It strikes. That's just to encounter and control the body. Another motion is when people are got a kickers. You got kicking people, come in and reverse. Mm-hmm. Now through the motion, you can use it in a speed. So it's, it can be like.
Whoa. Ah, you all right, Reggie?
Yeah, fine.
All right.
Okay, the other motion we have is a basic self-control of a Qi-style meditation.
Mm-hmm.
Before you even start, you have to have the mental and physical preparation.
Okay.
Okay, for instance, you have a big brawly guy coming from my size.
Like me, huh?
He's usually gonna either punch you straight or overhand.
Mm-hmm.
So I gotta slip him being able to strike into the counterparts of his body so I can avoid his strength and his power.
Exceptional.
Okay, the next motion that we have is control of the body and the mind with the lower legs.
Okay.
Okay, see this one here, he's coming in, you're attacking in a motion of a strike. And then here, you're reversing into the throw.
Whoa.
See, now if you were to use this full blown on the street,
mm-hmm.
most of the time, the person's gonna be hurt. That's why in martial arts training, you have to have control.
Okay.
The control is he your friend or foe?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of is he attacking you through mental concentration, through is he gonna try to hurt you, kill you, or take your money? So then that's when you have to know yourself what kind of technique you're supposed to use.
Now, Manny, real quick, what if this were, for example, for a lady being approached by a bigger guy? What are some of the simple moves, and then we'll get into the weaponry real quick.
Like if you're grabbing it and coming down, mm-hmm. and it's just a control. For when he's coming from my neck, into the neck.
Okay. See? Now, let's take a look, if we will. I want to thank you, Reggie, man. Watch yourself there.
Thank you.
I want to thank you. If you will, show us a little bit about some of your toys that you've brought. Yes, awesome. If you show us a little bit about your toys, what is that called?
These are the double swords.
Oh, hold on. Let's take the mat. Let's remove the mat, if we will. Yes, Reggie, appreciate that.
These double swords in China were known to create with the horse and the man on the horseback. Cutting up above, coming down, and rolling pattern, coming. In a motion so that you have create a high block from a spear or sword.
Yes.
Wheeling down, piercing in, coming across, and chopping.
Oh. That takes some time to learn how to do that. Don't try that at home, kids, if you're watching this.
This now, takes many years to do.
Now, what is that?
This is the daijo.
Now, should I stand here? I'm a chicken. I'll admit. Should I stand here while you do this? Or sit here, rather?
For the daijo, they have the horses. Okay. Mm-hmm. When the foot troop comes in, they only have this and these people on the horses. This is known to shear off the horse's legs. See, the motion is to block, counter, roll, cut, block, reverse, and set.
Awesome. Fantastic. Let's have a seat here. See if I can get you mic'd back up here real quick. And this has been, I tell you, for the people at home, I'm sitting here. This is really amazing. How long, again, did it take you to learn each weapon? Is there a particular
weapon? There's 18 classical weapons. Mm-hmm. Of the 18 weapons, the proficiency for each one probably is about 6 years.
Wow. Well, I want to thank you for coming on. It's been a pleasure, and hopefully I can get out to one of those studios, one of your places, and pick up a little self-defense. You say that I still have some type of hope.
Oh, you have a lot of hope.
I want to thank you. Right now, we're going to take a quick time out, but when we come back, Mark and I will be visited by the gurus.
Venom 1, this is approach. Suspect aircraft's inbound, heading 350.
We see him.
In 5 minutes.
The Air National Guard.
Good luck, guys.
Helping track and stop illegal drugs being flown into the U.S.
Move it.
Before they hit the street.
Thanks, Air Guard. We got them.
Got him.
Home early, Maria.
It's a surprise. Jimmy's birthday.
Be cool.
This is District Attorney Ira Reiner. If your child is involved in gangs, call. We can help.
Welcome back. I'm still shaking from that karate martial
arts. I felt bad for Reggie. I was ready to call the ambulance or something. I mean, the guy was getting flipped and flipped, but they're used to that.
And speaking of shaking, we have the gurus. Where are those guys?
The guys went out in the field to the Raider et tryouts. Thank God this is cable.
I'm going to say, I feel sorry for the Raiderettes.
And yes, they went out to the Raiderette tryouts, and folks, here's how it went.
Mark and Benji coming at you here from Los Angeles. We're at the Raiderette tryouts here at the Sheraton Hotel. And you know, it's a Sunday morning, it's pretty early. It takes a lot to get us out of bed. We think we finally might have figured out what it takes. That's cheerleaders, big time professional cheerleaders.
Mind if I say a word?
Please go ahead.
I think the reason I'm here today is to see the athleticism and the capacity of the full throttle motion of the kicks and the movements. And
I don't know about you, but I'm here for the babes.
There are about 190 girls here today trying out for the Raiderettes. Only 48 will make it. That leaves a nice sum for Mark and I to take home and console.
I'll say.
Played powder puff football for 2 years.
Were you the center?
No, actually, I was wide receiver.
Oh, well, next year I'm hoping to be a tight end.
Yeah,
I'll bet you are.
You may not have heard, but we are going to be trying out today for cool. The Raiderettes.
And the Raiderettes.
Got like your little G-strings
guys.
Yeah.
We're working on something that I think is going to be a little unique, sort of in our own little way.
They like you to be very loud and obnoxious. And
Really?
And
by obnoxious, what are we talking? Are we talking maybe burping, farting, that sort of thing?
No, that'd be a little rude.
You have to bend down because then there's no picture in the back.
Well, is this like a, just because I'm a Caucasian? Is that it? I'm sensing some hostility. I'm sensing some hostility.
Can we all just get along?
So we're thinking about strongly considering trying out for the Raiderettes.
That would be nice because you could be like your leader, that we could do stunts and, you know.
Do you think so?
Nice.
Because
yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is the 90s. It's about time I think there were some men in this thing.
And I was a cheerleader there too. And we had yell leaders and we did stunts and basket toss and, you know, sat on their necks and all.
Give me an example. Show me what you used to do in high school. Give me like a cheer, like 2, 4, 6, 8, here's one. How about this? U-R-I-N-E, urine, big trouble.
Okay. G-O, let me hear you say go. That's right. Unite, let me hear you say fight. W-I-N, let me hear you say win.
Win!
Together! Again, if you say go, I win!
Win!
People will do anything in front of a camera, won't they? Wasn't that television at its finest?
I think she would have eaten my sunglasses to become a Raiderette.
She would have eaten anything, if you know what I mean.
What do you mean?
And I think you do.
She has high hopes of becoming a Raiderette. I have high hopes, too. I feel like we're announcing like a golf match or something. Holy Hooters, Batman.
So what do you think of the 3-4 defensive set?
There's 17 Raiderettes in this picture. That means there are 34 heaving elbows. 34 luscious eye sockets.
34 big breasts.
It is Hooter heaven. I have died and gone to a beer commercial.
We have just learned a few steps from the Raiderette Handbook. Can we show you and see what you think?
Round and round and round. We got the feet. 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 We got the feet.
I'm going back. I want to find some tail.
They want you to be respectful.
So in other words, if we dance naked, we probably won't make it.
You probably won't.
You don't have a pair of tights I could borrow, do you?
No, I don't think so.
Okay, thanks anyway.
Well, we're taking a little break here at the Big Raiderette tryouts. We've been here for a couple hours, worked up quite an appetite. But, you know, I sort of feel like there's one major ingredient kind of missing so far.
Well, what would the Raiderette tryouts be without a pickle?
Ah, of course.
And, of course, if the Raiderette tryouts go a little sour, then...
Then you have the pickle.
Limp pickle.
Limp. There you go. We're going to go do some more scintillating interviews in just a moment, so stay with us.
Nothing like a good pickle to keep the day going.
I'll tell you.
Shave one day and shave the... Okay, and don't shave one day.
Okay.
Okay, shave one day.
Right.
Don't shave one day. Okay, the day after.
Right.
And then shave again.
I have no idea what you just said.
Shave one day and shave the... Okay, and don't shave one day.
Okay.
Okay, shave one day.
Right.
Don't shave one day. Okay, the day after.
Right.
And
that was a scholarship winner right there. Tell me how you feel right now.
I feel really good about it. I don't think you could be too perky when you go in there.
Perky? Perky. No. Perky cam.
Perky.
Very
perky,
nice.
Perky.
Let's see your perky.
Perky.
Perky. Very nice.
Let's see.
Okay, here we go. This is the guru perky cam.